What is API first? Is it the same as API first design? Is it a process, a methodology, a buzzword, or maybe all of the above? Today, we invite Brian Otten on API Cookery to talk to us about what API first really is. Stay tuned to find out more. Today, we have Brian Otten. Brian is an experienced leader and technologist with 25 plus years of experience and has worked with large enterprises to define API strategies to support digital transformation and continued growth. He is currently working as a catalyst for Axway, where he helps make businesses consumable by guiding them with the power of transformation with APIs. Welcome to API Cookery, Brian.
Hey, thanks, Brenton. It's great to be here. Yeah. Wow. You made it sound like I've been at this for a long time, and it certainly feels like it.
Well, you've had quite the career in tech and APIs, and I just wanted to pick your brain today. There's a lot of discussion lately about API first and what it is, and I thought you would be the perfect person to explain to all of us what exactly is API first.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of confusion about API first, and I like to distinguish API first by saying you really have to start with thinking about your business and how you're reimagining that business, or if you're starting out, you know, what is that business going to look like? So it's very much linked to strategy. It's very much linked to how you want to turn your business model or merge your business model with the emerging technology model. And for that, most companies think of that as, how do I either create a platform, a digital platform where I can take the world-class products and services that I've got and make them consumable, and then also extend that out so I can make my company really easy to work with and make all of those things consumable. And that's where the API comes in. So I think that's the distinction, is API first is then saying, okay, so if we have this view of our business as capabilities with the products and services that are going to deliver those, what would it look like if we just imagine that as a set of API products, meaning a bunch of APIs working together to get the data, to get, you know, to provide the access, to make it secure, and then that would be the API first way, is we start there. We don't start with building the applications or, you know, looking at the back end systems of record and all that. So it really is API first, and it's a big change for a lot of organizations, a big strategic move.
So from your experience, is API first a hard concept for enterprises to wrap their head around?
I think it is, and you have other kind of what I would call kind of sub categories of that, or practices within an API first strategy that come into play. So sometimes people confuse API first with design first, right? And design thinking and stuff like that. That I would see as part of the operations to create digital products, right? So thinking about design first is an essential part of API first. To make API first really work, you would do it with design first. I think a lot of people get confused and say, what's the difference between API first and design first? And I would say, you know, API first is the first thing, is having that map, having that view, that reimagined view of your business as a set of working APIs, interoperable APIs. And then within that, you're using things like, what is the value proposition of an API, right? What is the business model behind the product we're going to create? And then that informs a really good design. So you're not just building apps, writing code straight from there. You're doing the design first based on the API first way, which is, how did we imagine this solution, or how do we solve some kind of business problem and get some real business outcomes out of this thing? By having a good design as part of that.
That is so true. Doing things right from the start can help with every step of the process. And I'm glad you brought up API design first, because there is a lot of confusion out there about what the difference is between API first and API design first. From what I've found, a lot of the content that's labeled API first is really content about API design first. Another hot topic out there is full API lifecycle management. I know you've already touched on this, but how does API first fit into the full API lifecycle management process, or is it part of the process at all?
Yeah, it really is. It's if you think of API first as like a strategic approach, so that people are strategically aligned, the delivery is aligned before you even get started. That's the first part of it. But I think what I like to do and how we're helping customers work through this in a way that's real, where they're actually doing a delivery, is thinking about the life cycle as a set of pipelines of work, because that's the way it really works. You know, you mentioned all those, you know, I worked in large enterprises, large banks, large governmental institutions. And that's the problem, is that you do have operational stuff going on in various areas where people normally don't talk, or if they do, they don't have really good collaboration methods. They don't ever sit in the same room, and I know now we don't sit in the same room, but even the same virtual room, and you know, that's where the problems are. And so if we think about the people who are coming up with the innovation, the people who want to improve customer experience, the people who want to make sure that we protect your data and build a platform that's going to be, you know, taking the business into the next, you know, generation, and making sure that it's sustainable, building an ecosystem, all of that kind of stuff. That's business operational work. Somebody is guiding that strategy. Somebody's coming up with the ideas for digital products and needing to make those available and consumable, hence the power of the API first way. But then you have on the other end, another pipeline, which we might refer to as DevOps, right? And I know you're a very big DevOps advocate, you work with development communities, and that has seen a lot of area of improvement. And if you think about it, that's just one part of the life cycle. That's, you know, if you're improving one part of a system, that's great, but it's really the overall system that needs to improve. So I think a lot of customers that we work with, a lot of organizations have already taking great strides to do and improve their DevOps, to continuously deploy, to continuously integrate, to speed that process up from going from what is specified, what is the thing we need to build, to the code, to the running, to the deployment, to the change management, to the all of that stuff, and optimizing all of that, which is great, but there's something missing, there's something in the middle, and that's something I like to call product ops. So you've got the business ops I described, where you're taking that reimagined set of capabilities and doing your digital, you know, ideas and making them come to life through your platform. You got DevOps, but even then, you can't guarantee that the stuff that the people are doing in the business ops pipeline are actually getting that realized as something of value. And that's where product ops comes in, because product people think about value. They think about consumption, who's using it, right? And that, I think that's the missing link that gets so many organizations in trouble, because you know, you can't guarantee that what's coming out of the DevOps pipeline and finally getting deployed and running is really gonna solve the problems and quantify that and make sure that you can show that this is a success, right? How is my product launch a success? So I think that's a good way to kind of elevate and kind of say, how would a set of teams across a whole line of business, or even, you know, outside your business, how would they work together? And accepting the fact that there are different pipelines of work that need to have to kind of start to come together without so many hard walls and silos.
Well, I know you've taken this message to a lot of different enterprises across a lot of different industries, but if you had to guess what percentage of businesses and enterprises are aware of and maybe have a good understanding of the processes that they need to follow to create a successful API platform for their business?
Yeah, I would say most. I would say like 95%, I would say. And you know, most 75% of statistics are made up on the spot. But most of the organizations that I'm working with and that Axway works with, you know, we go in and they are aware, right? So you'll have a business transformation team. You know, I'm working with one large healthcare provider, and they have a business transformation team project. And that's the other thing, is thinking of it as a project is also a kind of a trap, you know, where it's not, it's actually the culture, it's the mindset, it's the behavior and communication practices, it's the technology platform that brings everybody together. That's really what we're talking about, right? And so companies will say, well, we are doing transformation. We have a maturity, a digital transformation assessment that we've got available on the Axway website. And it seems like a lot of companies are experimenting rather than kind of having a very structured approach to it. So I think that's, again, where API First really kind of helps bring stuff together, because you can take a transformation team that's really geared up, thinking about design thinking, thinking about the product ops world, and getting people in place who have that kind of mindset. But then you can actually join that up to how the stuff actually gets delivered and built. And I think that's the main challenge is, you know, like I said, the DevOps stuff has been going on. People are pretty mature. You know, we can release, we can do all that. But there's that, again, that missing bit. And I think that's the challenge. That's what I'm seeing, is that putting that piece in place where people are actually working together and sharing the risk and the reward is something that's pretty rare. And it's something we can help with, right?
Well, I, for one, I'm very grateful of what you do. You go out there and you educate people about APIs, and it's often hard to get really good, solid information about the complete journey that enterprises need to take to create a successful API platform for their business. And I do think it's crucial to have everyone from the developer to the CEO understand how important APIs are to business and how critical they are to everything that we do, whether it's banking, commerce, manufacturing, entertainment, and more. So many people I talk to want to know more, and they're committed to doing the right thing, but what right is can be very confusing when you have to start researching it. Again, I'm very appreciative for what you and others do to educate and equip all of us to create successful API products that produce business value, because in the end, that's what it's all about, creating business value for our enterprises. And I've seen a lot of the great resources that you've created, including blogs and videos. And so where would you tell people to go to learn more about API First and other API topics?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I would go first and foremost, obviously, because we're biased, but go to catalyst.axway.com, because that's where all of our Catalyst material is. You know, we like to think of ourselves, and I thank you for your comments. It's really kind of you. We are a thought leadership team, and in that sense, you know, like you said, a lot of organizations are looking to be educated, but then very quickly you need to move into how do we execute it? How do we do it? Right. So there's a lot of stuff available on the Catalyst section of the Axway website at catalyst.axway.com. We also have a series of webinars we called Around the Corner, which we did during the pandemic, the depths of the pandemic. And so there's a lot of information available there about KPIs, about, data ecosystems, building a successful API program. There's loads of really good stuff there, available there. There's the assessment that I talked about. So that's a good place to start. I'd also look to, all of the good work that's been done by some of the conferences that you and I have attended in the past together. And I miss that. I miss hanging out with you at those. But, things like API Days is a great set of events around the world. So I would look to those types of things to get more information and to kind of interact, as more of a community around APIs.
Well, there's a lot of great content in those sites that you mentioned, and I will be sure to include all those links in the show notes for this video. Well, thank you, Brian. It has been a pleasure having you on the show, and I've learned a lot, and I'm glad that we're able to share this with everyone.
Me too. Thanks for having me, Brenton. Good to see you.
I'm Brenton House. Thanks for watching API Cookery. Check out the show notes below for links and bonus content. Subscribe to this channel to stay up to date with the ever-changing world of APIs and digital transformation.